What's up, guys? Thank you for clicking onto this video. If you've watched everything, that means you're well caught up right now. And now, this is my life. I am actually at a shoot for myself and Bambio. And now I just want to take pictures and feel cute. So this is the first look. I'm all white. Showing a bit of my tunyamas because I, by the way, we weren't ready for this shoot. This is something we just decided to do with Babu. So I have the wrong undergarments, but we're gonna style it in a way that's, you know.
Like, yes. I have no Spanx, no nothing. Like, my everything is everywhere. Yeah, but it's just a 2-minute shoot. And it's also because this dress is white. So, yeah. Let's see how we look after. Could you ever? Could you? Yes. Yes. These are all Vivo products, by the way. So if you're concerned, if you want to know where they are from, Vivo. Vivo should pay me.
Where we're going to shoot inside. Oh, it's nice and green. Or Babu just changed his mind.
We're going to shoot there still, but.
After. Oh, look at this tree. Nice.
So after that mini photo shoot, guess what? I quit my job. Yeah, so that happened. I just casually just said I'm moving on to newer things. Yeah. Anyway. It was more serious than that. I know I'm making it sound a bit like relaxed or whatever, but it was more, babe. Yeah, Alvin will come and tell you his side of the story, my side. But I feel like I need to get to the next level of where my life is and stuff. So that's why I quit. But I didn't like quit. I just won't be styling majorly. I'll be more into the fashion side. What are you doing?
Right.
See, you got dressed. So that you come and talk to the people.
Oh, so what are you doing? You've hinted to them that I'm well dressed.
He's naked. We enjoy that. Oh my god, that's like one of the biggest pros of being just the two of us. We just walk around the house. It's so liberating, y'all. So liberating. Anyway, yeah, so. As I was saying, I quit for purposes of growth. Like, I need to move on to the next level. And it was becoming a bit, one, inconsistent and cumbersome and monotonous. So it's just the same thing. And then there's delayed payments. And then it frustrates me. And y'all know me. Like, I'm very systematic and order oriented. So when that is interfered with, I get a bit, you know. So anyway, now I'll be moving on to doing my own thing. I will keep you guys in the loop of what that is exactly. But of course, you know, I've been making clothes and styling, but now I want to focus mainly on making clothes. Like right now we have Dingo coming out. That's something we are co-doing with my husband. I'm working on Dingo. We are working on other stuff that I'm just not ready to share. Yeah, babe, sit and talk, people. Yeah, I was very close. I can get excited, but yeah. Sit, my husband, sit. Sit down.
Sit on this makeup thing.
Yeah, I was removing my makeup, so. Yeah, don't show them your lower body. Taboo. Hey, babe. So, yeah, this is us, fresh-faced. I just chucked my makeup with the... Yes.
This is me. I'm the cleanest of us all, because... in the bathroom. No, me in the bathroom are like this.
You shower a lot, by the way. That's something else you know. Alvin showers a lot. I thank you, Lord. But there are days you...
Hey! Nothing like it. But
babe,
what?
There are days you have to reminded.
No. What do you mean? I need to... Do you think...
Oh, you smell so nice.
That
yeah.
Means...
Yeah, so I was just telling them that I quit my job. What's your take on it? How do you feel?
My take on it is
Babe, be serious. This is going to inspire someone.
No, the thing is you have to assess pros and cons.
Yes,
make sure everything makes sense. Make sure you're self-aware about your efforts and you have a clear vision. You have good motivation. You have a good support system. And then,
My good support system.
Good support system and then go for it. Now, the point is this. It is always hard.
That is the hardest beginning. Thing ever.
First of all, maybe just quitting is number one.
Let me tell you. First of all, the thought of quitting itself is paralyzing. You're exactly. like, where am I going to get the money? What am I going to do? What is this, this, this? But then the first thing you have to do in such a situation is to pray about it.
Yeah, pray about it.
Get to know what God is saying about your situation.
Yes, and also it is you, remember.
At the end of the day,
you. Something we have learned, you know, for us, we call the hard times in our life boot camp.
Yeah.
So that's a problem. Having
it keeps us positive.
A fitness oriented hub.
Anyway. And a positive wife, since we are taking credits. Mm-hmm. Babe, anyway,
so,
what?
So the thing is this, we call them boot camps. And one that has stuck out for us here is you left your father's house. India. Mm-hmm. In front of you alone.
I wasn't ready. Anyway,
no, but it's the truth. Like, now you left, you're now out, you can pay your own rent and stuff.
Like, yo, things get serious.
That is a very simple way to say you are alone in this world. Doesn't mean that they have forsaken you. No, it's time to move on. It's time for you to take responsibility. Yeah. And also, sometimes, even if you need help, some people are not in the position to help you, be it even friends or what. Like, they want to help you, but they just...
They also can't. They're in the same predicament as you.
Work as though you'll never have help from anyone else. Yeah. Like, create your opportunities, literally.
Mm.
So, there's nothing like, oh, I'll just wait here. Then we shall get a sponsorship here. Then we shall... So, this one will come through. Where may I learn? By the way, do you know the first lesson I had? I learned... When I was paying a bride price, that's the first time I noticed.
This is why you should encourage men to pay bride price. It sharpens something in them. It sharpens
That's when
something.
I realized you're alone. The people you think that I will always come through, at that point, many people have told me this. Many people who have been married or anything. Like, to be honest, there are three. I'm sorry for my language, but I always call anyone pundas. It's just... A slang and I grew up. So the three pundas, in this case I mean the my good people, you know. And sometimes I'll say punda, which means bad people. So you have to be in context.
Yeah,
you
go with the flow.
Break and clutch, break and clutch. Yeah. So anyway, there are three guys who I knew for sure that number one's an ATC, trust me. Zero. But still God came through. And that's what God loves. Such situations to show you that
you can depend
on someone.
You
don't put your faith on people.
Yes.
Put it on me. And that's why his glory shines the most. And it makes the story sweeter. Makes the testimony sweeter.
And
so in
you
your hard times, I always tell people, enjoy your stories. Because now, imagine yourself. You're giving a speech. Babe, close your eyes. You're giving a speech. And you're telling guys about these stories of, like, for example. Are you closing your eyes? For example, there's a time I was riding. From training my client, sick, almost approaching 7. Riding, coming home, my friend, it's raining.
Sorry. My mom's sorry.
Now, you see, at that moment, I'm like, shit.
You're cussing out, yeah.
Yeah, any good, you cannot give me a car now, blah, blah, etc. But then... In future, when God has given you everything at the right time, you know, sometimes blessing at the wrong time is a curse. So everything has come at the right time. You'll say, you will laugh about these moments whereby rain chapped my eyes and I'm just squinting like it was heavy rain. So I'm there like a big guy.
You could have just get an Uber.
Listen, babe, there's a problem. I couldn't get an Uber, so I leave the bike there and what?
Yeah, and then you'll
the
like,
bike,
you need
the rain
tomorrow.
Caught me on the way. So I was busy going... I see, you know, when it's big droplets of rain, you're like, what?
Drops.
Yeah, it's about to. So I'm like, then
you're doing that to your mouth.
Hey, my friend. Then Then it's increasing. My legs are, say, burning up. I'm like, hell no. Hell no. Then so my mind says, stop at that petrol station. I'm like, yeah, when I reach that petrol station, I'm going to stop and take a break. I reach that petrol station, I measure the rain, I'm like, but I can just push on. When it poured, there's no pushing on because there's now nowhere to go. I was wet. And then it's like I cannot see. And that day I said, if I die, I die. If they're knocking me, let them knock me. Then I'm just like, it's hitting my eyelids. This one eye, a raindrop, chapazi there. I'm like, it was insane. So, but anyway, those are stories that I picture myself in future when I feel fulfilled, I will be telling. At that time, they'll be funny. But at the time I was going through it, it was hell. I cursed a lot. So yeah, enjoy your struggles. And
now you've taken this video like totally different. You're talking about quitting your job and the importance of going through hardships.
Okay, because those are boot camps. Let me go back. Listen, Jade. No, I bring the stand. I bring the stand. I can bring the stand if you're a handy.
I just wanted to tell you guys why I quit, how I did it, but no. Behold, Tabu, bring the stand.
Yeah, but this is a pimple.
Bring the stand. Yeah, he's bringing the stand because my hand is getting tired.
Let me first.
No, I'll just hold it here, but hold on. Yeah, so as you were saying, the reason why I quit, I know it's a bit insensitive considering guys are looking for jobs and life me hard and all that stuff. But this was done for me.
Yeah, that's the point.
For my personal growth.
For yourself, that's what self-aware.
You have to do, check yourself. Just take a day. Don't eat, by the way, this is what happened to me.
And Attila, I didn't eat. Call it, have a meeting with yourself.
Yes, bring yourself to a meeting. Don't bring any food or anything. Take a book with you and notes. Ask yourself, why am I quitting? What am I going to do when I quit? What are the pros and cons of quitting? What will happen to this team when I quit? How can I still solve the problem such that they don't feel my absence? Like, you have to ask yourself all those questions. And that's what I did.
And
like,
it depends
the 2 weeks before today. Yeah. I sat down and I did the pros and cons and I prayed about it and everything. And I was just like, yep, it's time to move on to the next thing. When I know it's not fulfilling me, forget the money. Money you'll get from anywhere.
Yeah.
When it's not fulfilling you, when you feel like you're not in line with your purpose and you're not in your most blissful moment or personality, then you're lying to yourself. You're just there for the money and now you're a slave. Yeah. You're not working in purpose. You're not doing the world any justice.
A guide for me is once you check your gut and you feel some discomfort, then just
that's time to leave.
It that's depends what it is.
That's a nudge from yourself telling you, you're me, apana, no. And then it's scary. For sure it's scary because now you're thinking, oh my God, now where is the money going to come from? Oh, but that's where now faith comes in. God has to find a way, my friend. So you want me to fulfill purpose? Show me the way. And then you can't think about what other people are thinking because even you won't be at your best self when you're working in an environment where you're not happy. That's not to say I was unhappy. Let me just clarify that. I loved my team. What I was doing, I loved it.
It's not that it wasn't happy. It's because your ambition.
Yes, it was being.
It reminded me of when I started fitness training.
Let me see. Yeah.
Yeah.
So I talked to him before I did it, and he was like, well, just think about it first, because you also don't want to act rash, and then you're like, you're forced to go back, umekunjamkia, you're just there, I was just joking, no? You didn't think it through. So that's why you get a second opinion from someone you trust.
Now just get in this.
And then now weigh your options. And I was so happy. Like, I'm telling you, my job was a dream job. The dream job, because I get to work with celebrities,
but
I get paid, I chill with the most fun people, most
literally
loving.
Literally, it was only a dream job for a season.
Yes, you need to understand the seasons also. Yeah. Because you can't be like, oh my God, I prayed for this, and then now it's a season to move to the next thing. But you're like, but this was my answered prayer. Now you're holding on to the past instead of moving on to the next answered prayer.
Yeah.
Yes, so I'm in transition right now.
Yeah.
I am I'm aware that there's going to be a shift and a change, and that's usually very uncomfortable and weird and different and new. Yeah. But
every foundation has to be laid.
Yeah,
it has to be hardship for the tall building to stay
strong.
Motegno.
Yeah, so that's, now that you've caught up, this is where we are now in life. Now that you've watched the other videos, that we are back. Now we are back, and that's us
but
giving you...
the way we are back is just going to share our life lessons, to be honest, man.
Yeah, it's not going to be vlogging every day, because for sure, now you know I won't be going anywhere. I'll still be working from home. We're telling you guys a few things, sharing recipes if you want. I'm going to, like, now be more on YouTube. You see, my quitting helps everybody. It's
not even
there. Right?
Let me tell you, she's under, I won't say selling, but she's not telling you what she's planning. She's just telling you, YouTube.
Y'all ain't ready.
She has something big she's working on.
Yes.
For herself, and that is what I want her to work on for herself. Let's stop touching my knees.
They're sexy knees. Yeah, okay, actually. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you so much.
But
if you need any
done.
More information, hey, please, you're talking enough. You need to regulate.
Hey, people, raise your hand if you still want me to say that. Yes, you. Thank you. So, as
no,
I was saying,
thank you so much for watching, guys. If you have any questions, please let us know in the comment section below. Now I'm at your disposal. I'll be more active. I don't know how active this one will be, but for sure,
I'm also working on something else. And for me,
yeah,
it's one thing at a time,
Babe,
to be honest.
Don't start talking. Thank you for watching. Subscribe. Guys, let's make it to 10K. Aki, guys, that would be nice.
But we have not been consistent.
Now we're going to be consistent. Now you can
Until
for real
consistent
subscribe.
For a
for
month.
Real. Babe, stop discouraging people.
I'm
and
not
trying
discouraging
to get
them.
Subscribe. Love you. Bye.
Wait.
Babe. To celebrate, we are celebrating what? My newfound freedom. Babe.
No, I'm just pretending how old people look at the camera.
Can you can never be serious?
We are celebrating newfound freedom.
Go away, I don't want you to celebrate anymore. Anyway, yeah, this is not, by the way, if we in any way encouraged you to quit your job, please don't quit on our account and say, Nessie and Alvin said so.
See.
Everyone's life is different. And everyone... Okay, you bite the knees, I'll vlog. I felt weird vlogging next to people. Everyone is just looking at you like, why are you talking to a camera sideways? What was I saying? Yeah, don't feel the pressure to quit your job because the economy is quite, you know, crazy. If you know you don't have that entrepreneurial spirit or you need a little push, then keep working. And then when you're quitting, make sure you don't burn bridges. That's the thing. You always have to maintain that friendship because like stuff could hit the fan and you have to like eat the humble pie, and that can be a very sour humble pie. So you want to just maintain that professionalism. Call the person in charge aside, tell them I want to leave because of this, follow the right protocol. And then it's not like they can force you to stay. If the policy or the contract you signed dictates that you have to give a notice, then you'll have to honor that notice. But if they can just let you go free, you go free. You know, so don't burn bridges because you'll need them at the end of the day. Somehow your paths will cross again, and you don't want to peter now with your boss somewhere in the streets and you're rolling your eyes at each other and stuff like that. That's not biblical. It's just not right. So make sure you end things on a good note, such that tomorrow you can still call each other and be like, how are you doing, like for real now, you know. Yeah, that's all I'd say. Okay, now for real we are ending this video. We want to go watch the movie. We're coming to watch Black and Blue. It's this movie by Tyrese. I hear it's nice. I saw the trailer and I was like, yeah. So that's what you're watching here at Prestige. this is our movie place. Like, if you follow us on Instagram, you know this is our joint. Yani, it's very exclusive. Like, there's rarely anyone ever. And then caramel popcorn, honey. Yes. Thank you for watching. If this video inspired you or changed your life in any way, kindly like, share, and most importantly, subscribe. You'll be seeing a whole lot of me now, because I can now focus on YouTube, and then you can ask me the questions you want me to answer in the comment section. And yes, see you on the next video.